Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat.
The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby.
The public never sees the work we put into maintaining this old building, but we put in a lot of work to maintaining this old building. And for me, I want to make sure that every time you come in, it's going to look and feel just as preserved and historical as you can. And then we're going to show you something really great on the screen.
What excites me about working at the Music Box is having the opportunity to bring all sorts of cinema to people here in Chicago. Whenever someone wants to see what's at the Music Box Theater, they're always going to be surprised. There's always something new. Cult films, classic Hollywood films, modern foreign language films, but also experience it in a communal environment.
Chicago has a long history of being a great film town in terms of exhibition. I mean, we had Siskel and Ebert here. I mean, everybody watched movies in Chicago. So the Music Box really, really kind of adds to it, right? That makes it a destination at times.
But what about us?
We'll always have Paris.
It was a repertory theater, so it played daily double features of classic Hollywood films. Over the years, we've also added more and more special events.
Where we bring in the filmmaker, we have the film premiere, or we have like a podcast about movies, or we do some silly event like a horror marathon, or we do a sing-along or a quote-along or some kind of interactive engagement.
Book signings, we're really become much more of a community center. So we're not just showing film, but we're showing events.
And makes Chicago in general a pretty cool place to live if you like going to movies. Every year people have their traditional Christmas event, and that to them is special, or they sing along Sound of Music, and that to them is special. And I think all of those things are to each person who comes out for it.
When I first started here, the theater was not showing Rocky Horror Picture Show. Management at that time didn't want to deal with the mess of having to clean up late at night after a screening. A few years went by and I finally convinced them, you know, you really should bring it back, because I think that that's the kind of programming we need to do. We can't just show films. We need to make them special. And what is more interactive and has more of a cult following than Rocky Horror Picture Show? So I convinced them to bring the film back, and we've been playing it on a regular basis ever since.
Somebody asked me to put together a list of people who've been here, and I started and I got back maybe 10 or 15 years, and I had like 80 or 100 names, and I was like, I'm done. Here, you can start with this list. We just had Bo Burnham here for eighth grade, and there was this really magical moment where a literal eighth grader came up and asked a question. And then Bo was like, I want to have a conversation with you. So he just stopped the Q&A and brought this eighth grader up, and they literally had a conversation about what it's like to be in middle school, and they talked about like consent and some of the other like kind of serious issues that the film brings up. But they did it in a way that was totally inviting and warm, and like the audience could understand, and he didn't put this eighth grader on the spot.
And you know, it's a conversation that a lot of schools aren't really having. You know, you'll have a lot of education about anatomy and not really a lot of education about the dynamics of a relationship, of being a boyfriend or a girlfriend.
And it just randomly happened.
For me, one of the highlights was in 2007 when I got a chance to meet David Lynch. At the time, he was self-distributing his film Inland Empire, and so I got an opportunity to introduce him and bring him out on stage, and it was a surreal moment, which is what you'd want when you're dealing with David Lynch.
70mm at the Music Box has actually had a longer history.
In 2002, we kind of reintroduced 70mm to our programming repertory. We shortly thereafter did Patton in 70mm, and then later in the year, we showed a 70mm print of Lawrence of Arabia.
We're getting chances to show new films on 70. I mean, we got Dunkirk on 70, we got the Paul Thomas Anderson film on 70.
I think that film is really important for a lot of different reasons. When you're seeing a movie on film, especially on 70, you are going to be seeing a higher picture quality and a higher degree of saturation than you're going to get with most other formats, especially digital. When you're running 35, you're just looking at small reels that are about 15 minutes to 20 minutes, and they don't weigh more than like 20 pounds usually. But a 70mm reel is going to be much larger. It's going to be roughly the same amount of time, but you're looking at like 50 pounds sometimes.
And then the sound is great because of the soundtrack that can be read, that analog sound that can be pumped in through the speakers, especially on 70 when you have 5 millimeters of soundtrack space to work with.
2001 Space Odyssey, which is my favorite movie, being able to project that on film and make sure that the presentation is spot on. I'm making sure that people experience it the way that not only that I want them to experience my favorite film, but the way that the filmmaker intended it to be experienced.
The experience that I hope every customer of the Music Box has is that they were able to take in its history and sort of the atmosphere that we create and also enjoy their film going experience.
On a big screen, with an audience, surrounded by an atmospheric environment is really what makes movie going special.
When the sound comes over you and that score hits and you know you're feeling what everybody's feeling because it's just, it's on you. You can't get away from it and you're just experiencing it together. I love feeling that with people and I hope that they come away, you know, realizing that there's still a magic to cinema.